So I decided I was going to do a little bit of vlogging today. I am on my way to the Women's Empowerment Luncheon by iDefine Meet Tour. It's by Kayla of the KG Lifestyle. So I'm going to take you with me to the event.
Unabashedly and say, let's be real, You know, because what's the point in doing all this stuff and talking about being natural on the outside if you can't be authentic on the inside? Mm-hmm. So regardless of all the accomplishments that I have, that you have, all the stuff, at the end of the day, we are women meeting each other, and let's make this moment of coming together count beyond just eating and drinking. Let's get real, let's go in, and let's define our next level of life. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
That struggle was interesting because a lot of people around me were telling me, hey, you look better with straight hair. And I was like, okay. I actually took that, you know, in and said, okay, well, I look better with straight hair. I'm gonna just wear my straight hair. For like 2 to 3 years, I just kept straightening it, damaging it. And then finally, I actually had an opportunity to move out of the country. And it was really hot where I went to live in Sudan, Africa. And I wasn't about to use, you know, a flat iron and it's like 100 degrees outside. It doesn't make sense. So I left my flat iron at home, and in Sudan, there's not really anywhere to buy a flat iron like that, so, at least where I was. And so I just let it go, and that was a real blessing. I actually had to be taken out of my element, you know, out of my surroundings, to really learn how to embrace what it was that was naturally me. So that was difficult, but it was a blessing, and now obviously I love it.
So for me, one of the things would be skin. I've always had problematic skin. I learned how to do my makeup at a young age. I cover up my face with makeup, and I always wore makeup. I was the girl who like wore makeup to the gym. And then one day I was at the gym working out, and I'm looking at myself, I was like, like, what are you doing? You're at the gym, you're trying to work out, you're trying to take care of your body, but you're covering up one of your insecurities. So it's just, for me, one thing that I've worked on is obviously working on my skincare routine, transitioning from like using proactive and harsh chemical products to a natural skincare routine. But with that, trying to become okay with wearing less makeup. Eventually, I'd like to be one of those girls who can just step out with no makeup on. Like, ideally, in my ideal world, I just want to be one of those girls. I woke up like this, and I just step out the house like this. It's been a process, but just really kind of accepting myself the way I am. You know, my skin is not perfect with no makeup on. I have acne scars. It's splotchy. It's not even. But just trying to kind of work through that has been one of my really, really big things. But it's still a work in progress.
How do you think that the natural hair movement has influenced self-acceptance, particularly amongst women of color? Because it's its own world. It is its own subculture. Mm-hmm. And I'm not even a year in natural, so I'm still learning so much. And I have to just say, I'm just like so proud of the movement. And it's given me courage by being around younger women who are so engaged. So, Kayla?
Okay. I think, obviously, I think it's wonderful, and I do think it has been, you know, the natural movement has been a seed that's been planted, and, you know, women can either nurture that plant and say, okay, I'm going to continue to try to really see who it is that I am. You know, more women are wearing less makeup because they're kind of like, okay, what am I putting on my face? A lot of women are watching what they eat now just because they, you know, return to natural, because they're realizing when they turn around, you know, the turn around the product they see that they bought, they say, okay, ingredient, I can't pronounce half of this stuff. They throw that away and then start putting more natural things in their hair. But then they turn around whatever they're buying in the grocery store. You know what I mean? They start looking and paying attention to more of what it is that they're putting inside of themselves. And I think that directly affects how they're, you know, how women are looking at themselves, how they're going to say, okay, I am going to accept myself in the way that, you know, I really am. This is how I am. And I can rock whatever I want to rock at this time, but I also want to know who it is that I really am. So I think it's beautiful. I think it's wonderful. I think it's interesting when it comes to, you know, different brands telling us what we're supposed to look like a lot of the time, still in our magazines and on our billboards, it gets overwhelming sometimes, but I think this movement is definitely, like, it's at war with mainstream media, and I love it. I absolutely love it.
Okay, look, just on that note, not only is it at war with mainstream media, but it's redefining the beauty industry.
Right.
I mean,
in the comments, a lot of times on my videos, I would see these ugly comments like, you know, I wish my hair was like that. I can't go natural because I have 4C hair. And I'm looking like, what? You know, and I wish I could trade with you. Like, I love, you know, kinkier textured hair. But I think it's interesting that women think that one standard of beauty is all that they can, you know, be. And I feel like that reflects in the inside. So because of that, like, passion that I had about seeing women really accept who they are, I did decide to make a video, and then it just slowly became, not even slowly, this, I made the video this year. So, you know, it became this thing where I was trying to really make people, you know, women who were looking at themselves and myself. I had, definitely have to say, I'm always looking within myself to see where I can improve. But just so we're not hating against each other because of texture discrimination, you know, looser curl, tighter curl over here. You know, people who straighten their hair over here that are natural, people who don't, you know, they say it's unnatural. Because you've colored your hair, you're not natural anymore. That kind of division, I just was not about it. So I wanted to make, you know, this event and really help women to say, okay, I define myself. I'm not gonna let anybody else define me for me. And so that's really where it came from. And I just decided, okay, I'm gonna do a little tour. Actually, it was supposed to be a meetup. So that's a little, that's a little background. But me and the UK vlogger I mentioned before, we were supposed to do a meetup of like 20 people. And it became iDefine Me Tour. So God just had a really, really different way of moving us towards where we were gonna move. And that's really where it came from, just God moving. So I'm really blessed. No crying.
It's natural to cry.
Yeah.